For years, the Yeti microphone has been the top-selling consumer-level microphone in the industry. If you've been on YouTube for a while, you know how popular it is with podcasters and streamers or all genres of video production. But in this video, I'm going to explain why the Yeti mic is probably not the mic you want, and we're going to discuss which mic you should buy instead. So I want to start off by saying that I actually like the sound of the Yeti microphone, and the engineering is not horrible. It's a pretty sturdy mic. It's a large microphone. A lot of guys out there don't like the sound. I actually think the sound is pretty good. So we're not really talking about the sound quality in this video. Instead, we're mostly concentrating on the use case. Is this mic actually right for you? Typically, people who will arrive at this video will want to use their microphone for podcasting or streaming, often to record audio while playing video games or podcasting audio content or audio from YouTube videos, demonstration videos, tutorial videos like this one. This is probably the way that you're going to use this mic. You're going to be sitting in front of a PC screen. You're going to have a keyboard in front of you. You're going to have a mouse on the right, and you need to find some way to get a microphone near your mouth. This is probably the format by which you're going to be recording audio, as opposed to other applications like recording a rock concert, or recording audio in an auditorium, or recording multiple people talking. If those are the attributes you're seeking in a mic, then this video doesn't apply to you. This video applies mostly to people who are using a PC and need to record audio at the PC. So, is the Blue Yeti mic right for this application? Let's consider our goals when selecting a mic for this sort of person. So I've outlined five goals here that would apply to such a use case. Number one, you want to position the mic close to the speaker's mouth. So as you may know, the way a microphone sounds is highly variable dependent upon the distance between the speaker's mouth and the microphone itself. The general rule of thumb that is so commonly used is you want to do the hang loose rule, meaning that you make the hang loose symbol with your fingers, with your hand, and that's about the distance that your mouth should be from the microphone. It's a good general rule of thumb, and if you notice, that's typically quite close, a lot closer than people initially think. So in choosing your microphone, you're going to have to find some way, some sort of mic stand, to get the mic close to your mouth. That's objective number one. For objective two and three, we want to have the speaker be able to see his PC monitor as well as use his PC keyboard and mouse. As we've mentioned earlier, if you've arrived at this video, you're probably looking for a mic that you can use in front of your PC. So you have a keyboard here, a mouse here, so you're going to need some sort of way to move this mic close to the mouth. But with the goal of not obstructing your field of view and not obstructing your hand's ability to manipulate the keyboard and mouse. This is the tricky part when it comes to selecting a mic stand, so keep that in mind. Number four, the most common problem you'll find with microphones, especially on YouTube, is you'll hear plosives in the audio track. Now, plosives happen when a burst of air comes from the speaker's mouth and creates an impact upon the microphone hardware. This causes that annoying thud sound, and it often happens with the words that have a P, like pizza. So I'm going to move my mouth to my own microphone now and try to create this effect by saying pizza, pizza, pizza. So my own software will probably fix some of that in final processing, but if that P sound was really annoying in your speakers, that's because you're hearing these plosives. You're hearing these awkward vibrations of the microphone hardware, which make for a bad hearing experience. And the way that we solve for that is to use a pop filter. This is typically a little plastic loop, which has a bunch of mesh in the middle, and it breaks up the air as it flows from your mouth, and it reduces the impact upon the microphone. Sometimes pop filters just contain a loop with a mesh. Sometimes they're in the form of a foam protective covering like this. So keep this in mind for later. We need a pop filter of some sort for our microphone. That was our fourth item. And finally, number five, the mic should not pick up desk vibration. So a lot of people ignore this attribute, but it is actually much more important than you might think. What happens is, if you plan on clicking your mouse button, moving your mouse around, or typing anything on the keyboard, the vector you create on these items will enter into your desk, and it will cause a vibration. And if your mic is right here and pointed like this at your mouth, then what happens is, this vibration actually travels up the microphone stand and causes the mic hardware itself to vibrate. And so if you're one of those guys who pounds on the keys or tends to shake the mouse a lot, then this is going to be causing lots of vibration here with the microphone that is very undesirable and can really ruin an audio track. So the way we avoid this is with a shock mount. A shock mount is a mount that goes on your mic stand, which pretty much often just contains a bunch of rubber bands or springs or some sort of elastic item which absorbs the shock that's coming up the microphone stand. This shock is dissipated through the elastic wiring which is holding the microphone hardware itself, so consequently the actual shock never actually reaches your mic hardware. Or in the least, it's suppressed enough such that it becomes irrelevant. So this is the final piece of gear we need, a microphone shock mount. Keep that in mind. That was the fifth item in our list. And so now that we understand the type of microphone setup that we'll be looking for, the question is, does the Blue Yeti microphone fulfill our criteria? Well, let's take a look at it. So when you buy the Blue Yeti, this is what you're getting. You're getting a pretty large and heavy microphone with a kind of unique metal stand. This is unique to the industry because most mics either don't come with a stand, they just have a boom arm attachment, or they often come with a little tripod, especially in these consumer level mics. But the Blue Yeti comes with this rather large and very heavy metallic stand. Additionally, there's a selector button on the mic itself, which allows you to operate in these four modes. Now, basically, this determines from which direction the mic is going to be picking up the audio. And surprisingly, many people often don't realize that depending upon which mode you select, you can vastly alter your audio quality. If you're doing podcasting or streaming and all the other options that we discussed earlier in this video, you always want to be in cardioid mode. That means the mic is set up to pick up the audio from the person speaking directly in front of it, which corresponds to this area right here. The mic is going to be picking up the audio right here that's going in the front of the mic. Audio from the other side of the mic is going to be muted. And so this is one of the first potential drawbacks, because most of us as podcasters or YouTubers, we're going to spend almost 100% of the time in cardioid mode, which renders the mic's directional switch mostly useless to us. We'll almost never use the other options. Now, if you're actually in a situation where you're going to be interviewing somebody face to face, then you might want to switch it to bidirectional mode, maybe. But again, for our purposes here, it's pretty rare that we would use any of these other options. We're going to be in cardioid mode the whole time, meaning that we need to position our mic so that the audio is flowing right here at the front of the Yeti mic. Keep that in mind. Once you actually get the mic unboxed, what you're going to quickly find is that you're limited in the number of places you can put it. Again, because it has this large metallic stand, if you want to actually use your computer keyboard, you're going to be left with pretty much one or two options. This person's not using a mouse in this photo, but if you had a PC mouse coming right here, then you literally only have one option. Your only option is to put the mic on the left of the laptop. So this is pretty much literally the one position you can place the Yeti microphone if you own a keyboard and a mouse and you want an unobstructed view of your PC while you're talking to the mic. Now let's recall goal number one. We wanted to position the mic close to the speaker's mouth. And as you can see in our slide here, if this is the only location at which we can put the Yeti microphone, then this is actually a pretty far distance from the speaker's mouth. Recall from the start of the video the hang loose rule. This tells us the approximate distance that we'd like to be from the mic. But as you notice in this picture here, this person's mouth is now quite far away from our Yeti microphone. Now, if the speaker wants to position the mic in a more viable position, closer to his mouth, then he's going to have to do what these two YouTubers are doing. He's going to have to place it right here directly in front of them. Now, the mic might be properly positioned, but the problem with that is if these guys had a PC and a keyboard right here, and the monitor is right here, looking directly in front of them, then how are these two people going to use their keyboard and mouse? And how are they going to view the monitor? They can't, or at least it'll be very difficult to do. Recall rules 2 and 3. We want the speaker to be able to see his PC monitor and use his keyboard and mouse. These two guys are going to have trouble doing that if their keyboard and PC monitor are directly in front of them. They're always going to be fighting the mic stand that is directly in front. So often, many YouTubers, after buying the Yeti mic, they quickly realize this and then they start buying more stuff. This is the next stage of the Yeti microphone user. What these guys have done here is flip their mic upside down and they've attached the bottom to a boom arm which is in turn attached to their desk someplace. And then they've positioned their mic in a top right orientation. Now, this at least makes things better because now their hands are free to manipulate their keyboard and mouse. However, they still do have a very large cylinder that's right in front of their faces. Here you can see this guy on the right. If his PC monitor is somewhere right here, he might have trouble seeing that. For the guy on the left, it looks like he's actually found a pretty good sweet spot, because if his PC monitor is right here, then for him, this might be significantly out of the way. Or it might not be, but as you can see again, we are violating our hang loose rule. This microphone is probably a bit too far away from his mouth. At least that's how it appears here. So again, this is not an ideal situation either. Now, if you look around the net, you'll find some other clever ways that people have tried to get around this issue. You can see this guy has got a pretty good setup with a boom arm. He also has a pop filter attachment hooked to the mic, and it looks like his positioning is still not quite ideal, but it's not bad. One thing we note is the position of his hands. If his keyboard is right here, then his hands would have to fight this part of the boom arm right there. The arm's a little bit low, and he's going to be obstructed if he moves his left hand. Here on the right side, we see another boom arm with a very large shock filter, and this guy has his mic positioned off to the left. Now, again, if you're doing streaming or podcasting or something where you have to see the PC in front of you, then your PC monitor is going to be right here, not right here. And when this guy goes to look at the PC monitor in front of him, he's just going to see this very large shock mount right here. And his vision will be obstructed by the Yeti microphone itself. And this is all to emphasize part of the problem with the Yeti mic, which is that it's actually very difficult to position on a boom arm. That's primarily because it only attaches from the bottom. It doesn't have any other degrees of motion around it. Right now, there's a guy on Etsy who's trying to solve this problem by selling a 3D printed microphone holder attachment accessory, whatever you call it. It's this thing right here. Yeti's parent company, Blue Mic, they neglected to build one of these things, so this guy is printing them from his own 3D printer and trying to solve this problem. And it looks like he has 981 sales, so it seems that a lot of people are recognizing the same problem, and they're stumbling upon this Etsy page. If I was forced to use a Yeti microphone again, this is the thing I would buy. I would pay the $15 so I can get this attachment, and then I would attach it to a boom arm so I could get good mic positioning right in front of my mouth. Remember, on the Yeti, because we're on cardioid mode, we have to talk directly into this sweet spot right here. We can't have our voice coming from here or from down here, or obviously not from the other side of the mic. We have to come right here when we're using the Yeti microphone. So as we've just seen in the last few minutes, the awkward positioning, the awkward manner by which the Yeti is mounted, makes it very difficult to use as a microphone for the type of applications that you're probably looking for if you're watching this video. It makes it hard to see your PC, and it makes it hard to use your keyboard and mouse. Now, as for our final requirements, we wanted to avoid plosives with a pop filter. But the Yeti microphone does not come with a pop filter. You have to buy it separately and attach it to the microphone base yourself, as this person has done here. Or you have to buy the foam attachment and attach that atop the microphone grill. So we have no pop filter to avoid plosives out of the box. And even more importantly, because the stand is so solid, it actually does a horrible job of preventing desk vibration. If you start pounding on the keys of this keyboard, the vibration comes through your table. This is a solid stand, meaning that it's going to convey the motion right up to the mic hardware itself, and you're going to get a thud in the track because the Yeti does not come with a shock mount. Recall that a shock mount is a system of elastic bands which acts to lessen the vibrations coming into the microphone hardware. So these are five basic considerations that you're going to be keeping in mind when you're shopping for a microphone. And unfortunately, the Blue Yeti microphone fails at all five of these requirements. So then the question is there a different mic we could buy that more successfully fulfills our criteria? Well, yes, there is. This is my favorite consumer level mic, the Fifine K658, which today is available for $76 according to Amazon. It's a lot cheaper than the Yeti, and yet I like it a lot more. This is the mic I'm using right now to record this video. I'll put a link to it in the description box below, and also probably an affiliate link if I can eventually figure out how to do that. But for now, let's review our criteria once more. First, can you position the mic close to the speaker's mouth? Well, this microphone comes with a boom attachment, which makes it really nice because it allows you to position it on your microphone boom arm. This guy in the photo is using the mic in pretty much the same way that we're going to be using it. Notice how his hands are free to use his PC in front of him, and that he has a clear line of sight from his eyes to his PC monitor. Since this microphone is off to his left now, he has these degrees of freedom right here. He can rotate the microphone left and right. Additionally, the microphone is a lot smaller than the Yeti microphone, so it's not obstructing as much of his field of view. It mostly just stays out of the way on his left side. To hold the mic in my own setup, I bought this little $27 mic stand from InnoGear. This is a short little stand that can just reside on the left portion of your desk, especially if you have a left return on your desk. It works really well for that. But in any case, this gives you a nice foundation to attach your mic to. For a visual representation of how my own setup works, I have a diagram here showing my PC in front. I've got the keyboard and mouse right here. I have the stand positioned right here on my left, and the mic itself simply screws into the edge of the stand, and this makes it really nice because since the metal bar in the stand is free-flowing, I can easily push this away or push it closer to my mouth as needed, and this makes for a nice setup. It's easy to position the mic close to your mouth. Remember our hang loose rule. We want the distance to be about the length of the hang loose gesture, about that far from the speaker's mouth. So that works good. Additionally, this stand can also rotate. We can come this way and we can move it up and down as well. So we have lots of dimensions of freedom here. It's very easy for me to see my entire PC monitor, use my keyboard, use my mouse, and we're fulfilling our requirements here. Close to the mouth, see the PC monitor, use the keyboard and mouse. Now for plosives, remember, we need a pop filter or a foam attachment to dampen our plosives from our mouth. The Yeti doesn't come with one. We have to buy that separately for the Yeti mic, but on this mic, it's built in. This Fifine mic comes with this foam attachment connected above the grill right out of the box, so there's nothing to buy. With proper mic positioning, I never found plosives to be a problem with this mic. It's worked out really well. So that was criteria number 4. Number 5, we wanted to avoid the desk vibration. And to do that, we need a shock mount. Conveniently, if you look right here, you'll see that this mic also comes with a shock mount, again, right out of the box. So again, there's nothing to buy. Any desk vibration from the keyboard comes down here and it's picked up by these little elastic bands that are around the shock mount, and so we don't get any vibration in our mic hardware. So in review, I hope these 5 criteria make sense. These are the 5 reasons why I personally switched from the Yeti mic to this Fifine mic last year. And I'm really glad I did. And again, like I said, I'm not picking on the Yeti microphone. I actually think the sound is pretty good. But for our purposes here, I think this mic, the K658 by Fifine, I think they just did a really, really great job on this mic. All at a very low price, too, for about half the price of the Yeti. You can pick one of these up and a little mic stand, and you could have a pretty good audio setup that doesn't get in the way of your home PC. So I hope this little video was helpful. Please leave a comment below and tell me what you think. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And thanks for watching.